So what happens to your body in an infrared sauna? Now, this is a common question. And it's actually a great question. Infrared saunas have become the rage over the past few years because they're purported, and there is some evidence from PhD YouTubers to the Cleveland Clinic, even Stanford, that infrared saunas can help recovery. They can help you be more energized through particularly mitochondrial regeneration and powering. They penetrate deeper, and so they help the muscle recovery, increase blood flow, and people overall have more energy. But if you're getting in an infrared sauna, the question becomes, they produce heat. After all, it is a sauna. And you know, if you use LED masks, we don't want heat produced from an LED mask. So if you go into this sauna, will you lose your facial fat? Will you lose overall body fat? Because one of the benefits of infrared saunas, of course, is weight loss. It's a big reason you see them in gyms. And I'm going to come back to that in a moment. But if you're getting weight loss, the question becomes, is it targeting facial fat loss? Before I get too far into this video, I do want to address the fact that there are videos out there and there are people that purport that because these wavelengths in the saunas penetrate deep into the body, even though they're naturally produced by the sunlight, these are man-made, deep, long infrared wavelengths that they feel like they're targeting the organs of the body, and that our body wasn't built to get that amount of energy with those long wavelengths deep into the body. So you will see people say that they feel that infrared saunas are harmful. And one of the interesting facts here is, when you go to the gym, and I know in my gym, that infrared sauna has been shut down since years. It's never been functioning. So people say, oh, they're shut down in gyms because they can't get insurances because they know they might harm people. So they're there, but they don't actually work. Comment below if your gym, if it's working or not. But that there's no evidence for that, but it is a narrative I wanted to address from the beginning of this video. Now, I know what you're saying. Fat loss has to be a great thing, right? Well, yes, in the body, but the problem is, and what people are complaining about is facial fat loss. And facial fat loss leads to sag, hollows under the eyes, hollows along the below the zygoma, below the high cheek, and that gives that gaunt look. Some people, of course, get that removed with buccal fat reduction, and then you see how old people can look. They age almost instantly when they lose that buccal fat, and there's dysfunction of fat pads. I won't go into the complexities of this, but understand there's deep fat pads, which are there to lubricate the muscles of the face, and there's superficial fat pads, and the superficial fat pads are a little more sensitive to heat, of course. That's why you see skin boosters is all the rage, because a lot of times fillers are placed deep and superficially. Now we're addressing those. So not all fat loss is good, especially in the face. So to understand facial fat loss, the first thing we have to understand is, what is the sauna? So there are three main wavelengths to think about here, because they're infrared. And remember, visible light is below this wavelength, and you'll see visible light in, say, your LED masks, red, blue, yellow, green. Those are all visible light. As we go to light or rays that you can't see, and in the saunas, you're going to have near infrared, mid infrared, and long infrared. Now your sauna, your infrared sauna is going to run at about 140 degrees F Fahrenheit. Traditional saunas run more about 170, 180 degrees F Fahrenheit. So you're getting the heating not from an element, but from these bulbs. And the bulbs that produce the heat are your mid infrared and your long infrared. Okay, so those wavelengths, your mask is going to be for your infrared that you put right on the face that does not produce heat, you're looking at around 830 nanometers. But when you go up to 1500 nanometers to 3000, that's your mid-infrared, and long infrared is 3000 to a million nanometers. Those are going to penetrate much deeper, and those are the wavelengths that some people do worry about. But for us, what we need to know is, you're going to burn calories while you're in that infrared sauna. How many calories? You'd be pleased to know 30 minutes in the sauna, you'll burn about 400 to 600 calories. Compare that to walking at a moderate pace at for 30 minutes, you're going to burn about 200 to 300 calories. So it's amazing for burning calories. If you lose too much body weight, of course you can lose facial fat with this. Some people are going to be more prone to losing facial fat with weight loss than others. Other people say, well, I lost weight, but I didn't lose it in my face, thank goodness. Other people are going to say, I only lost 5 or 10 pounds, but I look gaunt and old. And most commonly it's because you didn't take care of your collagen prior, so the skin has nowhere to tighten. It's more loose and lax. But what about the point of pointed fat loss from these wavelengths, from the mid and long infrared wavelengths? We know that the near infrared, that's around 830 to 1000, is pretty safe for the face. I'd say near 830 for a mask. But these longer ones that do produce heat, what about pointed fat loss? And that's what most people worry about. Well, here's the bottom line. There is no good data to say that these deeper penetrating longer wavelengths actually remove your facial fat from the sauna and the intensities that you get in the sauna. I will say that you want to limit this. Many saunas actually have a heating element, a Finnish dry, like Finnish meaning Finland, Finnish dry heating element, and some even have the wet capability, so that you don't always use these longer wavelengths in your infrared sauna. Like anything, if you overdo it, you'll lose too much facial fat, which of course brings me to something else that you might be asking. Well, why is it that some people with certain facial devices lose face fat? And you'll ask me about galvanics, about RF at home, about ultrasound. And here's what I think, and here's why it relates to the infrared sauna. I believe that there is a small group of people, less than 10%, maybe less than 3%, their facial fat is just a little bit more sensitive than most people to heat. Thus, a little bit of heat and they lose facial fat. But for the majority of us, that does not apply. Now, how do I know that? Well, there's some studies, but in clinic, when I'm using RF, when I'm using heating devices, we measure the temperatures. And a good rule of thumb for most people is 42 to 43 degrees centigrade for 20 plus minutes. And we can measure that. And I gave you the temperatures of at least the ambient temperature, the temperature of within the saunas prior in this video. But understand the question with the infrared light, the mid and long infrared, is that these penetrate much deeper than the near infrared. And so we just don't know. There's no real good studies to say, but from what we see, there's no pointed facial fat loss from the saunas when they're used, I would say, at moderate levels, a few times a week for durations of 20 to 30 minutes at a time. I think you are absolutely right to be concerned about facial fat loss. And if you want to know how to improve your facial fat or improve the functioning ability of your facial fat so you maintain the fat where you want it in a lifted manner, in a healthy manner, you're going to want to watch this video all about maintaining your facial fat pads, and one down here all about LED and red light. Keep your skin and body beautiful, healthy, and vibrant.